Hi guys, I'm Kasturi Sanap and I welcome you all to this video. What is that one thing which comes in your mind when you think about mutual fund?
Investment in mutual fund is subject to market risk. Please read the offer document carefully before investing.
Yes, there are so many advertisements which come in between IPL which says mutual fund sahi hai, mutual fund sahi hai. But kya mutual funds waqai mein sahi hai? Let's have a look in this episode. First of all, let us discuss few of the advantages of mutual funds. They provide diversification benefits. If at all you are supposed to buy all the stocks that a mutual fund considers, then you will have hundreds of stocks in your portfolio. That will lead to more transaction cost and less profits. But with the purchase of a single mutual funds, you can actually own all the 100 stocks. So yes, mutual funds provide you with diversification benefits at a very, very low cost. The second important reason why you should have mutual funds is professional management. You as an investor probably may not understand finance and probably may not understand the science of investing. So you need a professional person who can tell you which stocks to buy, which stocks to sell, who can tell you where to invest and where not to invest. So a mutual fund is that particular manager. Mutual fund has got professional managers who help picking stocks. The next important point is liquidity. You can buy mutual fund today, you can sell it tomorrow if you require money. Mutual funds are traded in secondary market. Most of them are traded in secondary markets. They are called as ETFs. If at all they are not traded in secondary market, you can withdraw your money anytime. You will have to pay an exit load in case of few mutual funds. But yes, you can withdraw your funds. You can withdraw your money anytime by selling your fund. So mutual funds are quite liquid. It is not like fixed deposit wherein your money is locked for a specific amount of time. The fourth important advantage of mutual funds is that there are variety of options. If at all you want to invest only in large capital funds, then there are large capital funds, mutual funds. If at all you want to invest in the complete Nifty 50, then there is an index fund. If you want to invest in growth stocks, there are growth funds, there are value funds to suit your requirements. So there are tons of options available. There are also few advantages linked to mutual funds. The first one is you don't have control over your money. You cannot tell the portfolio manager or the fund manager which stock to purchase, when to exit. So you lose control on your money. Whatever is the professional manager, whatever is the manager going to decide, that stock the fund is going to buy. So you lose your control over your own money. Secondly, many people, they do loss harvesting, which is an efficient form of saving taxes in which you report losses in a particular year to offset your capital gains. But that cannot be done in case of mutual funds. Mutual funds will decide when to buy a stock and when to sell a stock, what is the capital gain that should be reported. So eventually you will have to pay capital gains taxes. You cannot do tax management if you are investing in a mutual fund. The third and an important drawback is that there are many active managed funds, which are different from the passively managed funds in a way, because passively managed funds try to replicate the index, whereas actively managed funds will try to deviate from the passive strategies and earn the extra return. So these active managed funds, they have a huge management fee, which increases the cost of managing those funds. So it is heavy on your pocket if you're investing in active kind of a fund. The next and a very major disadvantage is cash drag. Mutual funds have a requirement to keep certain amount of money idle for either operation purposes, or if people want to remove their money, they have to keep some money idle with them. So that amount, it cannot be invested in the market, and that is what results in something which is called as cash drag, where your returns are declined because you cannot use the complete money. So tomorrow, if at all you invest say 10,000 rupees in a mutual fund, then the mutual fund is going to keep 2,000 aside with it, and it is going to invest just 8,000 rupees. You won't earn any interest, you won't earn any return on that 2,000 rupees. That is a cash drag, that is called as cash drag. So yes, cash drag is an important problem in a mutual fund. So in this episode, we have discussed few advantages and disadvantages of mutual funds. So you have to decide whether to invest in mutual funds or not invest in mutual funds. If you think that I have missed any of the advantage or disadvantage, then please note it in the comment section. Stay safe, guys. Please do wear masks. See you in our next video. Thank you.